Welcome back to Bricsys channel. In this video, you will see how to print 2D drawings and 3D models using model space and paper space layouts. This is a family house drawing with plans, elevation, and section in model space. Before printing, we have to do page setup. Print settings are controlled by page setup. I'll access the page setup by right-clicking at the model tab and I'll click on page setup. You will get the page setup dialog box. At the printer plotter configuration, you can choose any desired printer from the list. I'll click on print as PDF because I want to plot to PDF file. At the paper size, I'll retain ISO A3 as the paper size and I'll retain millimeters as the units because I've created this drawing in millimeters. At the plot area, I'll define the area to be plotted using a window. So I'll click on this arrow, pick the first corner of the window here, then move the mouse and I'll pick to define the opposite corner. I want to plot this ground floor plan. Next, click on the scale pop-up and I'll click on 1:100 as the scale because I want to plot in a reduced scale. Next, I'll choose the plot style table. The plot style table specifies how entity colors are used to control colors, line types, and line weights on paper. Now I'll choose monochrome.ctb as the style table. Then I'll choose landscape as the drawing orientation. Then make sure that plot entity line weights and plot with plot styles is on. I won't activate plot transparencies because transparency property is not given to any of the entities. Now I'll click on preview to see the plot preview. Everything is plotted in black and white because you have chosen the style table as monochrome. Now you can see that the paper size is big. So I'll reduce the paper size from A3 to A4. I'll click on paper size and I'll choose ISO A4. I'll also do a bit of editing on the monochrome style table. I'll click on edit plot style. Click on the form view tab, click on color 1, then I'll change the color from current color to blue, so whatever is drawn in red color will be shown in blue. I'll also change the line weight from object line weight to 0.6. Save and close, then click on preview and you can see that whatever is drawn in red color is shown in blue and you can also see a change in the line weight. I'll give OK. Now you can go for a direct print by right-clicking on the model tab and click on the print option. You will get the print dialog box with all the settings you have specified in the page setup. Now you can change any of the settings if required, then preview the plot, then go for a print. Now I've asked to specify the location of the print. I'll keep it on the desktop and the file name is planmodel.pdf. I'll click on save. This is your PDF plot. Next, we will see the procedure to print this 2D drawing using layouts or paper space. We already have a layout here in the name layout 1, which is the default layout. I'll click to activate it. You can see a default viewport here and hit delete key to erase it. Next, I'll do page setup for this layout. So right click on layout 1, click on page setup. Here, I'll specify the settings which was given in model space. At the printer plotter, I'll click on print as PDF. Then paper size, I'll select ISO A3, 420 by 297 landscape orientation. The millimeter is already chosen as the unit. Under plot area, the layout is already selected because I want to plot the layout. You can retain the scale at 1:1 because we will be specifying the scale inside the viewport. Next, the plot style table, I'll retain at monochrome.ctb. I'll activate display plot styles because I want to see the plot styles on the layout as well. I'll choose landscape as the drawing orientation. Plot entity line weights, plot with plot styles should be checked. And I don't want to plot the transparencies. Rest of the settings I'll keep in the defaults. And I'll give OK. This layout indicates an A3 size paper. and you can see a dotted line, which is the plot margin. Whatever is beyond this plot margin will not be printed, so you should see to it that your drawing is well within the plot margin. Next, I'll create viewports in this layout. For that, I'll click on View tab. Here you can see Paper Space Views. Just click on that. Now I'm asked to specify the first corner of the viewport and the opposite corner of the viewport. You can see the drawing in the model space appearing with the settings specified in the plot style table. I would like to keep the elevation drawing in this viewport. So I'll just double click to activate this viewport, then pan the screen a bit and zoom in to keep this elevation here. Next, I'll control the scale of this viewport. For that, I'll double click outside the viewport to deactivate it and click on the viewport border, click on the properties panel, and here you can see the standard scale as custom. Just click on that. I'll bring down the scale to 1:100. Now it is pretty okay. I'll just resize this viewport a bit by clicking on this grips. Then press escape to deselect the viewport. This elevation drawing is shown in 1:100 scale. Next, I'll create another viewport to show the sectional drawing. I'll specify the first corner here and the opposite corner here after tracking this point so that the edges of the viewport will be in the same line. Then double click to activate this viewport, pan the drawing, zoom in a little bit, then double click outside the viewport, click on the viewport border, click on standard scale and change it to 1:100. But here, when you double click to activate the viewport, and if you zoom or pan, you will lose the scale. So using a procedure, you can lock the scaling inside the viewport. For that, just double click outside the viewport and select these two viewports and click on display locked option and choose yes. Now if you double click inside the viewport and zoom in, you will be zooming the entire layout and not the drawing inside the viewport. Next, I'll create another layout in which I'll keep the plan drawings. You can easily copy a layout using the copy option. So I'll right click at the layout tab and click on copy. Now I'm asked to give the layout name. I'll call this layout as plans. I'll rename the layout 1. For that, right click at the layout 1 tab and click on rename. And I'll call this layout as elevation and section. Give OK. Now I'll click on the plans layout and right click and click on page setup. Now you can see that you have got all the settings which you have set for the previous layout, so that you don't have to set it again. And you can make necessary changes if it is required. I'll give OK. Now I want to perform panning inside this viewport. So I'll select these two viewports and I'll turn off the locked status. Now double click to activate it. Now you can pan inside the viewport. You can see the ground floor here. Just double click outside the viewport and you can grip edit the viewport borders so that you can see the entire plan. Next, double click to activate this viewport and you pan in such a way that you can see the first floor plan. Then double click outside, grip edit the viewport borders to see the entire drawing. Now you can print this layout using the same procedure you have seen before, that is by right clicking on the plans layout and click on the print option. Or else you can print the model space as well as all the paper space layouts in one go using the publish option. But before that, I would like to change the page setup of the model space. So I'll activate the model space, right click and click on page setup. Then click on window and I'll capture the entire drawing within a window. Then I'll activate fit print area to size of page option so that the drawing will get fit within the specified paper size. I'll change the paper size to ISO A3 in the landscape orientation. And I'll give OK. Now I'll click on the publish option in the toolbar on top. Now we have various options in the publish dialog box. You can either publish the model space or layouts or the model and the layouts. You can see everything here. the layout names and the model space. Then you can publish to the plotter named in the page setup. The plotter named in the page setup is PDF, or else you can choose PDF from here if you have specified some of the plotter in the page setup and you want to plot to PDF. You can specify the location here. I'll keep the PDFs in a folder called print on the desktop and I'll click on publish. Now the publishing takes place in the background. Once it is finished, you will get a notification that the background publish finished. Now I have opened the print folder and you can see the drawing in the model space as well as the two layouts, that is the elevation and section and the plan layout. Everything got printed in one go. Next, we will plot the 3D model of this family house. I'll plot a layout. So I'll click on layout 1, then erase the default viewport, then right click on the layout 1 tab, then click on page setup. At the printer plotter configuration, I'll choose print as PDF. Plot area is the layout and plot scale is 1:1. Then plot style table, I'll choose displayColors.ctb because I want to plot in colors. Drawing orientation, I'll choose landscape. Rest of the settings, I'll keep on the defaults and I'll give OK. Next, I'll click on the view tab, paper space view. I'll pick the first corner of the viewport here and the opposite corner here. Then I'll create one more viewport. Then double click to activate the first viewport. Then I'll click on the view pop-up and I'll choose friend view. Then double click to activate this viewport. I'll go to view pop-up and I'll choose right view. Then I'll select these two viewports. I'll go to properties panel. I'll click on standard scale, keep at 1:100. Then I'll escape to deselect. Double click to activate this viewport. I'll pan the drawing a bit and I'll make adjustments on this viewport by grip editing and enlarge the size of this viewport. Now I'll right click on layout 1 tab, click on rename and I'll call it as elevations. Next I'll right click and copy this layout and I'll call it as perspective. Now I'll click on the perspective layout tab. I'll erase these viewports. Then I'll click on paper space view. Pick the first corner here and the opposite corner here. Double click to activate this viewport. Then right click at the lookup icon and I'll click on perspective. Shift right click to orbit the view. Then I'll zoom in and I'll change the visual style to conceptual. Now we have two layouts. In the first layout we have elevations and in the second layout there is a perspective view. Likewise, you can create as many 2D views as you want from a single 3D model using layouts. Now you can either print or publish these views based on your requirement using the same procedure explained earlier. This concludes the tutorial on printing 2D and 3D drawings in BricsCAD. Thanks for your time.